If we took a piece of hair out of our head, cut it in half, just like you would cut a cucumber in half, and looked at it under a microscope, we would see that it has three major components. This outer layer, this is called the cuticle. The cuticle makes up for 20% of the hair strength. When you have split ends, damaged hair, it's all happening in this layer. The hair cuticle is clear. It's transparent. It's basically a clear coat. Let's say we paint our nails red and we're gonna put a clear coat over that. This is what the cuticle does. It's just a protective shellac. So when you're seeing someone's hair color with your eyeballs, you're seeing what's under the cuticle. This is just, again, a clear protective layer. In the next few weeks, we're gonna be talking about the different types of hair color. Temporary, semi-permanent, I'm missing one, demi-permanent. So this will all kind of tie in together later on down the road. But for now, just know if you have a damaged cuticle, that is going to make your hair color look darker because you've essentially got holes, big old potholes, in your protective layer. So when we deposit darker hair color, whoop, whoop, because that space created there, it visually looks darker. When you put a strand of hair under a microscope, it looks like this. Oh, kind of looks like tectonic plates. Anybody remember tectonic plates? It looks like scales, they're overlapping. And again, it's clear. You can kind of think of it like glass. So when I put a temporary hair color over my hair, it's doing a physical change. It's not doing a chemical change. In order to do a chemical change, you need to go to the next layer. So temporary hair colors just stain that glass, that clear cuticle, the top coat. So if I put a temporary hair color, to squirt it out of the bottle and it's blue, I'm essentially just staining the outer layer of my hair for a short period of time, hence the name temporary. Let's say you wanted to do a permanent hair color. That's when the chemical change is taking place. Now remember, the cuticle is tectonic plates or scales that are clear. When you do a chemical change with permanent hair color, the color molecules slip through those plates to get inside to make a chemical change. Here comes the color molecule. Woo, gonna slip through there and just make a physical change. I guess today is green. To make a physical change, it has to be penetrating. Could you use another word? To make a physical change, it has to be in the cortex, which is this layer, the next layer. I just realized I drew one too many holes. Sorry about that. So here's our diagram again. This is my cuticle, the thin outer layer. This is my cortex, the second layer. This is giving hair up to 80% of its strength. In this layer, this is where you're gonna find melanin, which determines our hair color. Our hair color is like our skin color. It's genetic based. So in here, you're gonna find melanin granules, which you can just think of these as chocolate chips. They range in sizes according to your hair texture. All texture is the diameter of an individual hair strand. You can have fine, again, if we're looking at this under a microscope, fine texture, medium texture, and coarse texture. Small, medium, large, fine, medium, coarse. The texture, how big around is your individual hair strand. The diameter, remember when you did the diameter of a circle as a kid? So melanin, the little dots here, or the chocolate chips on a chocolate chip cookie, according to our texture, are distributed differently. The melanin in fine hair, which is like mine, is packed tight in there. They are grouped together tightly. What this means is when we color our hair, or fine hair in general, it's going to absorb hair color faster, quicker, which is faster, and it's going to look a lot darker. If I put a level 3 on fine hair, it's going to look like a level 2 or a level 1. It's going to appear darker. Medium textured hair has a normal amount of chocolate chips, nice even spacing. The hair color reacts normally. You don't have to do a special formula like this one using a lighter shade. It's the easiest to work with because it's the most predictable. For coarse hair, the chocolate chips are spaced out. The melanin is spaced out. This means it's going to take more time. It's more resistant. If you have gray hair, you may have experienced several different hair textures over time. For example, my hair is fine, but I'm starting to get gray hair. It comes in as coarse. It is harder to color coarse hair because, again, it's more resistant. There's more space here that I need to fill up. And don't worry, if that's a little confusing, it's going to tie all in together when we start getting into gray coverage and different hair types, textures, colorings, permanents, etc. Our last layer is in the the center of this donut, and it is called the medulla. Some people call it the pith or the marrow. It affects hair color in no ways, because again, the cortex makes up 80, the cuticle makes up 20%, so 80, 90, 100. This is literally nothing in according to hair color. Some people don't even have the medulla. Blondes, people with fine hair, thin hair, they are missing the medulla. Quick recap, if we pull out a single strand of hair, well, fun fact, it will grow back. If you pull it out without doing damage to what's under it, which is called the papilla. The papilla, it's a pilla for the hair. So this is our hair strand. You know, when you're tweezing, waxing, or whatever you're doing, and it has a little bulb on it. Okay, that's called your hair bulb. The papilla is a little sac under here that controls the blood flow. If this part gets damaged, no blood flow to it, it stops the hair from growing. It's damaged, it can't grow. That can be from trauma, hormones, age, a lot of different factors to consider. If you are experiencing hair loss, the best way to treat that at home for $0 is to take these digits. You're just gonna do this. You're just trying to penetrate the scalp. You're just massaging it. Put some oil on there. Trying to generate blood flow. The hair papilla, the pilla for the hair, supplies blood for this to grow. We need blood to stay alive, just like your hair needs blood to generate more hair. Does that make sense? Anyway, sorry, I love fun facts about hair theory. Back to the hair layers. All right, so if we pull out a piece of hair, it's gonna have three main layers. The cuticle, the cortex, maybe not the medulla. The cuticle is the outer layer. It's the shellac. It's the top coat. It's the clear coat of wax on a car. It is responsible for 20% of the hair strength. When you have split ends looking like this, sometimes like mine, sometimes they'll look like this. That means you've done damage to your outermost layer, the cuticle. You need to repair the cuticle if you can. The best way to get rid of a split end is to chop it off, sister. You can fill in the gaps with Olaplex, protein, whatever, but to totally repair that sucker, just cut it off and start over. The cuticle is see-through. Again, it's the top coat to my nails. If I paint my nail blue, the top coat is clear. That's my cuticle. I can still see the blue under it. It's just a layer of protection. I can stain my cuticle, the top coat, with temporary hair colors, and those are physical changes, changes that appear different with our eyeballs, not chemical, not permanent changes. Under the cuticle is the cortex. This is where all the sciencey stuff, hair color, changes in melanin is happening in the cortex. It is 80% of the hair strength. The cortex holds the melanin, the hair color that we're born with, our virgin hair color. And the hair color that we choose to lighten or darken is all happening in the cortex. If I color my hair black, the color molecules are going to zoop through the cuticle, the scale-like tectonic plates, and rest in the cortex, making a physical change. And I can see that it's black because all I'm looking through is a top coat, the cuticle. Hair color just changes melanin granules. Melanin granules. Remember the chocolate chips of the cookie? Depending on my hair texture, which is the diameter, is it fine, medium, or coarse? That's gonna determine how many chocolate chips or pieces of melanin I have in my hair. Medulla is the middle layer. It doesn't serve a purpose. Remember, people that have fine, thin hair like myself, blonde hair, they are going to be missing the medulla. Hope that made sense. I know it's a lot of information. We'll connect all the dots when we break down the types of hair color. If you have any questions, video requests, please leave them below. Don't forget to check out my main channel. It's an entertainment channel. I'm there every single Sunday at 1 p.m. Eastern time.